This is Frankie Frank, and he wants you to know that he hates Prime. When I first saw this video, it caught me off guard because Prime is a pretty popular drink. Due to KSI and Logan Paul's successful marketing, as well as its limited availability, it's become something that a lot of people see as a novelty. Ever since it released, there's been a constant demand for it from both kids and adults. Schools have banned it due to it distracting kids who'd rather drink it than study, and fights have broken out in the UK over its scarcity. Whether it's just a trend or not, people are obsessed with this drink, and shorts of Prime in them can get millions of views. When Frankie showed up on my For You page, I thought he'd just be another fan. One of those people who make videos talking about and promoting their love for the product.
We got Prime, boys. We got Prime.
I could not have been more wrong.
I'm tired of Walmart trying to sell this trash drink. The funny thing is...
This is a man who sports a level of hatred towards a drink that I didn't even know was possible. His entire account revolves around hating on Prime and trying to antagonize its creators. In this video, he fills up a flytrap with it just to show how much he dislikes it.
Supposed to be filling this with water. The funny thing is, look how many I got. I'm the real Lord of the Flies. Logan Paul and KSI, I'll knock you out.
Notice how he calls out Logan Paul and KSI at the end. He does the same thing in this video where he's hitting Prime with a tennis racket.
Who needs tennis balls when you got Prime? Logan Paul, KSI, serve that!
I like how he attempted to hide the Prime with the tennis balls like some sort of plot twist, but he failed to cover them so you could still see them. One of Frankie's most frequent videos is one where he'll get somebody else to try Prime, and then they always spit it out and talk about how gross it is. He does this with people on his street, fair workers, and even a solar panel salesman, if you can believe it. Yeah, no way that's scripted. And if it is, get this man an Oscar.
The funny thing is, Logan Paul and KSI, thank you for getting me free solar panels. I'll knock you out.
Just like I mentioned earlier, he continues to call out Logan Paul and KSI, telling them that he's gonna knock them out, and what I'm gonna take a wild guess and say is boxing. So what's somebody who wants to box a different creator want? Attention. Okay, so pretty much Frankie hates on Prime as a way to get views. He's somebody trying to get people's attention by trashing Prime and trying to start a feud with its creators. And that's not really anything new. People have been starting beef and getting into feuds with other creators forever. Usually both creators just want views, and at most the feud will just result in a boxing match that is very profitable for both of them. Unfortunately, in Frankie's attempts to get noticed, a lot of his videos go to lengths that are very excessive and wasteful. So here is Frankie destroying Prime with a baseball bat. Here he is shaking Prime around at Walmart and making a mess. And here he is mowing Prime. Gotta hand it to him, he's creative with how he hates on Prime. But he's definitely destroying the bottles. No one's gonna be able to drink those. I don't know about you, but it seemed like kind of a waste to crush some Prime for a video. Sure, taste is subjective, I'm sure he really does hate it. But there's a lot of people who would be more than happy to drink those. Here he is throwing entire cartons of Prime into a crusher to be destroyed. And at this point, you can see that he's crushing Prime on a much bigger scale than just a couple cans and bottles. He drives over and crushes several packs into the pavement here. He even throws Prime into the ocean. Obviously, he's doing this for content and to get a reaction. Maybe a couple years ago, you could find some people who would find this hilarious or upsetting, but most of the comments are just flaming him. The number one thing that people point out here is that he is not hurting Logan Paul or KSI by doing this. But also that he's just generally acting like a fool. Dude just gave them like $200. I don't think they mind. I mean, he low-key helping Logan Paul and KSI. Bro's been doing this for years and still hasn't got noticed. Bro don't know how much money Logan and KSI are making. A grown man doing this is crazy. Funny thing is, you still buy all that Prime. You're their biggest fan, dog. Now, unfortunately, wasting food on the internet is nothing new. And there have been several videos that talk about the most common type, which is these videos where people put a bunch of food together into these excessive and stupid displays for views. Most people who do this follow a formula of having the food be in the forefront while they just kind of stand back and make all these faces or reactions. Although the videos are often intentionally messy, they usually at least keep it contained inside their house. But Frankie does not keep it contained inside his house. He does it differently. He uses multiple construction vehicles to make his videos as grand as possible. But here's the thing. Frankie doesn't just destroy Prime. The reason I compared him to those other creators is because he also destroys food.
You guys wonder why there's a wing shortage. But the funny thing is, I'm sure this is pissing a lot of you guys off. But who's actually gonna step up and do something?
Here he is throwing wings off to the side after just a bite and another bid for attention. You could have the benefit of the doubt and say that somebody's off camera catching those wings and saving them for leftovers, but that's probably not happening. Because in this video, you can clearly see that the wings are going straight into the dumpster. Okay, so playing devil's advocate, you could say that they're still gonna eat those wings. They're gonna take them out of the garbage and still eat them because they don't waste food. You might think that he just wants to convince the viewer or commentator that what he's doing is real to make them upset, but ultimately he salvages it. The little weight that that argument has is unfortunately dissolved by the fact that he also makes videos blatantly burning dozens of burgers more than once. And the comments aren't mad, they're not frustrated. Nobody's laughing at it, they're just disappointed. Help the homeless people. Bro, give it to the homeless. Give it to a homeless person. No freaking out or chaos, just asking him to stop wasting the food. The worst part is that in one of them, he says that he's burning McDonald's burgers because they are disgusting and bad for your diet.
He's down the many double cheeseburgers been sitting on this fire now for about 10 minutes and they won't even burn. And you guys think this is high quality food? Well, the funny thing is, I know y'all are gonna cry about these, all 40 of them on the fire, but you ain't gonna do nothing about it. So step up and defend your disgusting diet.
Obviously, McDonald's is not healthy for you, but this is such an ignorant thing to say because there's so many people who can't afford something outside of McDonald's. Healthier food costs more. Burning food in front of people online and telling them you're doing it because it's unhealthy seriously shows a lack of perspective. So you might have noticed that Frank has a seemingly unlimited supply of wings, prime, and fly traps. And you might be wondering where he gets them all. Well, believe it or not, Frank actually provides answers to these questions. In this video, he says that he gets a lot of his food from this deli.
I'm tired of you guys asking where I get these wings from. Pay attention this time. Irma Deli, when you call, tell him I thank you.
But what about the prime? Well, he actually made a video saying that he gets them with an EBT card.
I wanna know how much I spend on prime. Well, the funny thing is, I don't spend a dollar. This is on the government's tab. EBT, everybody eats. Logan Paul, KSI, I'll knock you out.
Look at that. I didn't even notice there was a second cart next to him. I thought it was a display shelf. I don't know where Frank is from, but I'm going to go on a limb here and say it is probably not possible to get that much prime with food stamps. So he's making it up to try and get people more mad. Don't forget, he is going to destroy all of that prime. That's all he's done in his recent videos. All those perfectly good meals and drinks being destroyed that millions of people around the world wish they could have. All of it being destroyed for a reaction he's failing to get. Nobody's gotten mad. I found like one or two people who are like, heck yeah, man, we love wasting food. But that was just like two people. I don't know what they're on about. They're probably other food wasters. But besides that, Logan Paul and KSI have not noticed him. So he hasn't really accomplished anything outside of funding more food destruction. Of course, we can talk about how wasting food is bad because you are destroying something that other people die from a lack of. According to the World Food Program, 9 million people die of hunger every year. Over 4 million have already died this year. So it's unfortunate that Frank is destroying something that other people desperately need. Since he's been doing stuff like this since December, I'm going to assume that he does not care. Food waste, world hunger, none of that matters in the pursuit of content. But the thing is, even if he is doing it for content, it doesn't even work. Clearly nobody's angry enough to give him a lot of watch time, they just wish he wouldn't do it. So Frank, if you're watching this, let's throw out all that empathy and everything I was whining about and talk from a purely business perspective. We're gonna go full heartless capitalist, oil tycoon onceler to prove how stupid this is. What's the best way to make money? I have a solution that would not only be much less wasteful, but also will help you have a better career. Give the food away. Maybe you're thinking, why should I do that? I already get millions of views from destroying it. Putting aside the fact that you clearly have enough resources to make hundreds, if not thousands, of international or local people happy, it would just also be better for you as a creator. I can tell that you are somebody who is passionate about content creation. You've been consistently uploading creative and high quality content for 2 years. You're good at it. Sure, you're destroying food and doing really questionable things, but it's really just awful taste, good execution. But your time could be much better spent just giving away the food instead. Just look at Mr. Beast. He had dozens of great video ideas, from counting to 100,000 to reading every word in the dictionary. But it wasn't until he tried giving away to somebody else that he blew up and is still riding that momentum to this day. You can't argue with this because he is literally the number one most successful creator on YouTube. So what does that tell us? Well, it tells us that we're not in 2016 anymore. The amount of people who are interested in and entertained by toxic and destructive content has significantly dropped over the years. Maybe a couple years ago you could build a brand around this, But the internet has grown up. No one wants to watch good food be destroyed, and that's why it only works in the form of short content. Millions of people tune in to watch 10 to 20 minutes of videos of not just Mr. Beast, but even smaller creators giving stuff away. But no one is gonna sit still for over 20 seconds of you destroying food. It's the opposite of appealing content. That's why this kind of content only works in 10 to 20 second bursts that take the viewer off guard while they're scrolling. And then the shock wears off, and the best case scenario is that you get a hate comment for engagement. I've also noticed that you're very keen on branding. You seem to understand the importance of having a character or phrase that people can know you by. Your catchphrase is the only thing in your description, and you say it in every video. And that's a good idea. If you have a phrase that people associate you with, you're gonna have a much stronger presence on the internet. But the thing about branding is it doesn't matter how consistent or well implemented it is, if no one likes the message behind it. You can make shirts, hats, and mugs that all say, "The funny thing is," and people might even recognize your channel from them. But nobody's gonna wanna wear a shirt with that phrase if it only elicits thoughts of destroying food and being insensitive. If you commit to building a brand on toxicity, it's gonna be really hard to break off from it in the future. Just look at iDubbbz. He made content that was wrong and toxic, only to realize too late that he had cultivated a fan base built on those same principles. He often had to interact with really weird and annoying fans at conventions, because that was just the sort of example he gave them. If you wanna try this new and very plausible direction, you still can. Even he still can. People don't know you as well as iDubbbz, and this idea that you're always gonna be somebody who wastes food and acts with this behavior is not completely cemented in people's minds. So you can definitely still change your brand for the better. I don't care how long you've been doing this. It's in your best interest to change your direction as a creator. Think about it. People love a redemption arc. You have 500,000 followers who know you for being wasteful, reckless, and rude. Most of which probably don't even like what you're doing. Imagine what would happen if you started giving back instead of taking away. It would be an amazing story you could tell on podcasts and make all sorts of content about. Maybe you'd even finally get noticed by Logan Paul and go on the Impulsive podcast. You could talk about how you used to waste food but realized it was wrong and changed for the better. You clearly have a lot of resources at your disposal but are just unfortunately doing the worst thing with them. I wish you luck as a creator and hope you stop deleting food. Food waste is a genre on TikTok that I can only hope becomes more relevant with time. A lot of people don't care what they have to do for views, and the only way for them to stop doing something is for it to stop getting attention. My hope is that audiences continue to mature to the point where this sort of content is no longer viable. We've seen it with a lot of edgy and toxic content from a couple years ago being replaced with a new wave of kindness and generosity, and I hope that trend continues. For anyone who's made it to this point in the video, I just want to give a huge thank you for watching. If you like this video, I recommend checking out this one where I talk about a weird celebrity AI. If you're interested in that, go check it out. Otherwise, I'm Lufa. Look at this, I bought a bottle of Prime for the thumbnail. Notice how it's empty.